for multiple things, which will, most importantly, as I think is a key thing for the university, retention. Currently, we have 3 people that participate and aid the students in the misconduct process. Dr. Groh, Ed McCourt, and Jody Cavins. The way the process is set up now, it's basically an email process where Dr. Groh gets notified of a misconduct through the academic misconduct form. He sends an email to the students giving them their options. They have 3 options. They can appeal, they can just agree with the decision, or they can say they don't agree, but they'll just accept the consequences. They respond to their decision, and then Dr. Groh emails the student and tells them to contact Ed McCourt and Jody Cavins. They both have distinctly different things. Ed McCourt has a specific plagiarism training that he has them do in the Writing Center. Jody has a reflection paper that she asks them to write with guidelines of what she wants, and then all 3 of those steps have to be complete. They have to responded, had the training, and completed the paper in order for their misconduct hold to be lifted. The way that AccuCampus can aid and assist is it actually can be automated. The emails can be sent by just clicking a few buttons. Eventually, we can send text to the students in case they don't read their emails. We're working on that through AccuCampus. And for the portion at the Writing Center, since they physically have to go in there, it can be set up so as soon as they go in and sign in, it automatically completes that step and notifies Dr. Groh that that's been done. It will also aid in reporting, making reporting a lot easier. Right now, it's an Excel spreadsheet that just kind of seems to accumulate, and not everybody has access to it. All of the reporting can be done in AccuCampus, and so it'll show you where they are in the completion process. Also, how many times they've been on academic misconduct. If more than once, you'll be able to check all of that. And then AccuCampus has actually already done all the setup for us, so it's pretty minimal. It's also completely customizable. We're working off of the emails that currently are in place, but they can be changed in any way that we want. It will require Dr. Groh to use AccuCampus kind of minimally. He really isn't going to have to do a lot. It might seem like a lot, but it's really only about 4 or 5 clicks each time. And then the best part of the whole thing is it is all locked down, so only the people that are given access, like Dr. Groh, Ed, and Jody, would be the ones who would actually see this. No one else would ever be able to know that the student is on misconduct, but it can still be reported on from henceforth. So I'm actually going to show you now how this looks. Dr. Groh, I'll do his process first because he would be the first person to do this. So he would log into AccuCampus and go to Action Plan, All Plans, and then type in the student name. We have Test Student. Okay. He hits Search. So she, because she's our test student, this will come up later, she has gotten an academic intervention form, and I'll talk about how that can tie in. But if he goes to show all, he'll be able to see if she's ever had any other misconducts, if she's had any academic intervention forms, anything like that. And what he does next is assign the action item. At this point, he comes in, he selects the JU Academic Misconduct Notification, which has the brief description that the dean has issued a citation and that they need a response within 7 days. We have set this up because we say 7 business days in order to make sure that the time frame is covered because reminders can be sent. We set it up for 9 days, which would cover any weekends. The date can always be changed. It's an automatic thing that's put in there, but anytime it can be changed. All he has to do is enter the course information, which comes on the form, so he will know what it is. And then he hits autocomplete based on rules, which that's something like when Ed, if in the Writing Center, when they swipe, it automatically completes it if they follow the rules. And then all he has to do is hit save. If the professor wants notice that it went out, he can just simply add the professor's email or any other person that needs notification. So now he'll see academic misconduct 1. That gives them the 7 days to respond, which technically is 9. So on the 9th day, if they have not responded, they'll get another email telling them, you have not responded yet. you need to complete this. This stays in this like yellow non-complete box status until they respond. And yellow actually means that they haven't done anything yet, but they're also not past due. If it's a red box, it means they cannot complete it and it's past due. And then if it's a green box, as you'll see later, it's completed and they're good to go. So they respond, let's say they have responded to him, and they decided that they wanted to appeal the decision. In that case, it doesn't go any further in AccuCampus because there's a whole separate system that has to happen then. So he would literally just come in, he can write in a brief note, but the student will see this, but he can just say appeal so we can keep track of it later. And then he completes it. And then if he hits save, that's where it stops, and then the appeal process is handled that way. If he doesn't, if they have decided either of the other two options, whether they agree with the decision or they don't agree but they're accepting the decision, then he comes back out here. He never would have clicked in here to begin with. If they are just gonna go ahead with the next steps, he does assign action pack. And as soon as he clicks on misconduct process, this will automatically, it also gives, this is a 7-day deadline, which also can be changed. He will click on autocomplete and save. And now this has sent an email to the student explaining that they need to go to Ed to do the training, and that they also, they'll get an email from Jody explaining the steps of the paper and that they need to email her the paper when they're done. And I think I can show you normally, it's pretty quick. Also, all of the people involved get an email. So Jody would get notification that her email went, so she could keep track, and so would Ed, so he has a heads up to be looking for them to call. There's an example of one. I had one in here. Yeah, so this one says, hello, Laura, visit the Writing Center. These are the instructions that you need to follow to do that. And then this is also Jody's email saying that you need to complete all of these things and to submit your reflection paper. We need to tweak this a little bit. Like I said, it can be changed in any way that we need to. So those have been sent out, and now we're going to go back and just check and see the status. It's in the right place. And it's just simply going back to all action plans, typing in the name, and show off. So now they have three outstanding things. The misconduct three is not complete yet because they have not finished everything. It would only be complete at this point if they appealed, and then the other two would not show up. So next, if they go to the Writing Center, there's a couple of things that can be done that are not set up yet, but it's very simple to do. Right now, they can just go, they can sign in. There's no specific service for the training itself. That can easily be set up by AccuCampus, and when they call Ed to make an appointment, he could make the appointment in AccuCampus under training. As soon as they walk in and sign in, it completes it. Also, if there's a service created and he doesn't want to actually make the appointment, he just says, come in on Friday between 1 and 3. They can walk in, sign in, and only the students with misconduct will see the option of Writing Center service or training for plagiarism. They select training for plagiarism, it's automatically complete. At this time, we don't have the service set up, so they would come and meet with Ed. He would go in and say, they met with me, and now this step is complete. He literally just has to mark it complete and hit save. Now Dr. Groh has gotten an email that says they have completed this portion, and now we should be able to see that misconduct two has been completed. Jody does the exact same thing. We don't ask them to come to the center, so they don't need to sign in, so she physically would have to go in like that once they've received the paper. Now she can do a couple of different things here. And they're telling me at this point, if she unchecks public for student, and maybe she notices something in the paper that they had some life event, that they might need some other reason for all of this, and they might need some additional help. They might need to go to the counseling center or something. She can put some notes in here that only Dr. Groh would see, and he could decide what the next steps are. He could say to her, great, knock yourself out, try to get them the help that they need, and we could then, through AccuCampus, track the progress of that student to make sure that they got the help. Or she can simply say, great paper, it was a misunderstanding, things are handled, that kind of, whatever she wants to say, or she can say nothing at all. And she just marks complete, like Ed did, and hits save. So now Dr. Groh's gotten two emails. He's gotten the one from Ed, and he's gotten the one from Jody. And that is where he's ready to lift the hold. And this is where I think it has simplified things for him the most. He goes back in, he can set it up so that he gets every single, he can do it daily, he can do weekly, monthly, he can have a report actually set up for him that he gets that will show him the completion of all the students of where they are in the process. So he will see if steps one, if misconduct one, two, and three are complete, he will then be able to say, okay, it's time to lift the hold. He doesn't have to rely on, oh, did I get an email from Ed? Did I get an email from Jody? Do I have to keep searching those? He can see that this one is only partially complete. I don't know why it's partially complete, but she's the one that we want. He will, at this point, go back in. I'm sorry, this is actually my fault. He will go back in at this point to a complete misconduct one because they have completed all three steps. So now he can do, he can tell the registrar that it's time to lift the hold. This way he know, and this way it's also reportable on where they are in the process. So if we know a whole bunch of people have them into the writing center, maybe something's happened to the writing center, it's been closed. If it's getting close to registration time, he can say, he can call Ed and say, oh, is there something we need to do to help you? You know, Jody can go in and say, I think we sent this a long time ago and I haven't seen them. Why haven't they contacted us? Even though they would have gotten reminders based on those deadlines. There's also times that maybe somebody will call and say, I can't get this done in time, but I got a reminder. We can go in and change the due date to extend it out so they would get another reminder if they wanted it, and then we knew that we gave them that time, and that could also go in the notes. So like I said, he can just have this email to him if he wants to do it every Tuesday morning. He just pulls this up and says, oh, look, they're all done. So all I need to do is go back in and mark them complete. So he'll mark the first one complete. And then he's gonna go back. Now he's going to assign one more action item that will take just a second. So if he assigns this and he does remove misconduct hold, this will be set up to automatically go to the registrar. And at some point we'll talk about whether they can do it. He hits save, and it sends a registrar an email that says they've completed everything, please remove their hold. We'll talk in a minute about how that can automatically be complete. At this point, it will stay incomplete until he is notified in some way and goes in and completes it himself. If the registrar comes on board or even just gets access to AccuCampus, they'll complete it. It can also be, the best way to do it is to actually have them on board, have them complete it, and an email is automatically sent to the student saying your hold has been lifted. And they can be specific that it's the misconduct hold and not any other hold, so that the student is not confused. So that's essentially everything that can be done, except for the best part now, assessments. With all these reports, there's several different ways that assessments can be done. One of the easiest and first things to do would be to actually do a questionnaire with Ed, Jody, and Dr. Groh to see if this helped them, if this is a faster process, if it keeps them more organized, if it's helped better for tracking. That can just be a simple survey. We can do reports on the completion rates, so we can even see how many people didn't complete the steps and then didn't come back, how many didn't complete the steps and are still somehow registered. We can do all of those things. The thing that I like the best about it, excuse me, because it deals most with retention, is misconduct versus academic intervention. We can compare the two. All of these reports, you can show them on the screen. They can be a PDF, they can be an Excel file, or a CSV file. And then these can be turned into, you know, you can filter, you can do just about anything that you need to do with it. You can also merge them with the AIF reports and then filter by student. So we can see, you know, did these people remain in school? If they have this much stacked against them, did they get the help they needed? And did we keep them? Or what do we need to do better next time? The way the AIF is set up now, they automatically, if they come to the tutoring center and swipe, it completes that notification that they got. So then we also can track that way to see if they've been helped. So the other thing that we can do, as we talked about, is referral to other services. The Career Service Center is, also part of AccuCampus. I believe financial aid is going to be part of AccuCampus. I'm not 100% sure about the counts, So we can see if we refer them to other places or what usage they have at those places and see if that helped them along the way. So there, it's not just a, hey, is academic misconduct done? And did we report on it? So that's about the entire thing that it can do. Like I said, it can be completely tweaked any way that we want. And hopefully we can start next semester to make it a little easier for everybody.